This is the MSI RTX 5090 Suprim Liquid, an RTX 5090 with a different take on cooling. Just how chill is it? How does it stack up against the Founders Edition 5090? And who is this GPU actually the right fit for? We're gonna talk about all that right here, right now on Robeytech, after a word from our sponsors. This video is brought to you by our official Robeytech build mat. If you've been watching the channel for a while, you'll probably recognize it. We love these things. They're super thick and durable, and they're absolutely huge in size, measuring at 5.5 millimeters thick and 24 by 48 inches wide. This one that we have right here, man, this has been in the studio for like 4 years and it's still holding up great, no problem. We've also included all sorts of useful graphics showing different PC form factor sizes, including schematic diagrams and connectors you'll encounter probably during your PC build. Not to mention, there's plenty of open space for screw and tool organization. We designed it like this so no matter what skill level of builder you are, it could be a helpful tool for pretty much everyone. Now, you can find these build mats for sale on our Newegg store, and it's a great way to support us directly if you enjoy the content we make. Thank you so much for your support, and let's get back to the video. Let's say you're looking for a new GPU and that your mind and wallet have agreed on the beastly 5090 as the perfect candidate. Chances are that this 5090 was not the first one to come to mind in that decision. But if the MSI RTX 5090 Suprim Liquid exists in this world, we want to know why. And we want to know what sets it apart, how it compares against the RTX 5090 FE, look at what kind of PC case it would fit inside, and more. But before we get started, we want to say a huge thank you to MSI for sending us the RTX 5090 Suprim Liquid for our testing. Let's get to know this GPU a little bit better, starting with the price. In case you're wondering, the MSI RTX 5090 Suprim Liquid is not an entry-level RTX 5090, and it comes with a non-entry-level price. At the time of this video, this GPU had an MSRP of around $3,200. Now, we did also see it hovering at a sale price of around $3,000, so you might see some different prices if you're shopping around. Now, when we look at comparisons, the Suprim Liquid has competition from cards like the Gigabyte RTX 5090 Aorus Extreme Water Force, which we've seen retail for around $3,700, and the Asus RG Astro LC, which we've seen for a staggering $4,700. Now, we're seeing some inflated numbers here, but at its current price, the Suprim Liquid is around 50 to 65% more expensive than the MSRP Founders Edition card, if you can actually find one of those FE cards at MSRP. Now, when we look at out-of-the-box overclocking above stock frequencies, the Suprim Liquid boost clock is about 4.4% higher than the FE's when using their silent BIOS profile and around 6.5% higher in MSI's gaming BIOS profile. Not too shabby, which is a similar phrase we'd use to describe the aesthetic of the GPU. Now, the actual GPU itself has a silver and black design to it with some RGB accents and branding, while the 360 millimeter radiator that's out there in the back, that's black with some silverish gray accents to it. Interestingly, we've seen two different schools of thought with design for these liquid-cooled GPUs. MSI and Gigabyte are team hoses on the end, while Asus is team hoses on the side. However, MSI and Asus team up for team fan on the GPU, while Gigabyte is strictly team no fan, no problem. Now, we can't really comment whether this combination is better than the other because we haven't tested them all yet. But if you have an opinion on which you like better, leave it in the comments. And you know what, hey, why don't you hit those like, subscribe, and notification bells? That would be great too. Now back to the RTX 5090 Suprim Liquid. As far as physical dimensions go, the GPU itself takes up about two PCI lanes, and it's about 280 millimeters or a little over 11 inches long, not counting the hoses. Now the radiator, on the other hand, needs space for about 394 millimeters or 15.5 inches to fit. This puts us in an interesting place where we can talk about recommendations for PC cases that a GPU like this might fit in. Ideally, you want a case that can support a top-mounted radiator for your CPU and a side mount for your GPU's radiator, and preferably enough room left over for some intake fans. If you're a fan of dual chamber cases, the Li & Li 011 Evo LX, Be Quiet Lightbase 600, or the Hightwise 70 would absolutely work fine. But if you're more into tower style cooling like the Corsair Frame 5000D, which we actually have a review of right here, the Fantex NV7, or the APNX C1, these all tick the boxes of having both front and side air intakes, as well as room for a radiator on top. Or you can check out this build right here, which is the Corsair 6500X, which is gonna be my main rig and is using the GPU we're talking about today. Now moving on to the cooling design, as we actually already mentioned, the Suprim Liquid opts for a hybrid cooling system using liquid cooling and a built-in fan to cool the RTX 5090 instead of relying on air alone. It's also worth noting that MSI did something really smart with their power adapter. The part that plugs into the GPU is bright yellow. This is MSI's way of helping users make sure that they've plugged in the cable all the way, which is pretty smart. But if you do find that you're having trouble with your Suprim Liquid or you have any concerns about making a purchase like this, MSI does offer a 3-year manufacturer's warranty based on your purchase date. Okay, so now that we know more about this GPU, how does the MSI RTX 5090 Suprim Liquid perform versus the NVIDIA RTX 5090 FE? Now for our testing, we kept the Suprim Liquid on the gaming BIOS preset to give an apples to apples comparison. Now we're gonna throw some specs for our test rig up on the screen so that you can get an idea of where these numbers are actually coming from. Note, we are gonna be using an Intel Core Ultra 9 285K here instead of a 3DV cache equipped Ryzen processor. We just wanna get the GPU to shine on its own. Now we're going to look at a couple data sets in gaming on both 1440p and 4K with and without DLSS. Starting with native performance, the MSI RTX 5090 Suprim Liquid held averages between 1.5% and almost 5% higher than the 5090 FE. In our 1440p native test, Doom the Dark Ages had the highest percentage uplift of 4.86%. When we look at the data side by side, these percentages translated to anywhere between a 2 to 3 frame per second difference in Cyberpunk 2077 and Marvel Rivals to a nearly 10 frame per second difference in Indiana Jones. The margin is ever so slightly thinner when we add in DLSS. Here we see a 1 to nearly 3% uplift from the Suprim Liquid, but this time Cyberpunk and Forza are the percentage leaders. Again, we're talking about single frame per second differences here, but we are seeing consistency in the Suprim Liquid's ability to stay ahead of the FE. Moving on to 4K native, the numbers are gonna look far closer than what we saw at 1440p, but remember that we're leaning harder on the GPU here. At 4K native, we're talking about a 2 to 3 frame per second difference in Cyberpunk 2077 and around a 4 FPS difference in Forza, but Doom the Dark Ages, Indiana Jones, and Marvel Rivals all put a 6 to 7 FPS delta between the Suprim Liquid and the RTX 5090 FE. And finally, when we add in DLSS, we saw a similar story to what we saw at 1440p. The differences are slim, but the Suprim Liquid held a marginal lead over the 5090 FE. For Cyberpunk, Forza, and Marvel Rivals, the lead looks like an average of 1 to 3 frames per second greater, while Doom and Indiana Jones average 6 to 8-ish frames per second greater. So we wouldn't call the Suprim Liquid supremely better than the FE at gaming, but it did stay consistently ahead of the FE here without having to lean on MSI's extreme performance profile. Now the bigger distinction though is power draw, thermals, and noise. From a power draw perspective, we do see the Suprim Liquid drawing over 4% more power on average than the FE under load, while staying around 0.5% under the FE in our gaming benchmarks. For context, it's nearly a 25 watt difference under load and about a 2 watt difference while gaming. Now keep in mind that the Suprim Liquid has a few more fans and a pump to power here, so it's not altogether unsurprising to see the difference under load. That being said, the fan on the GPU itself didn't feel like it was coming into work while we were actually testing, it just kind of sat there. As for thermal performance, this is one of the places where we see the Suprim Liquid really shine, and it should. It's got its own freaking radiator. During a test, we saw the Suprim Liquid average just over 46 degrees Celsius while gaming and around 59 degrees Celsius under load. For context, that was between 28 and 29% lower than the FE while gaming and nearly 25% lower than the FE while under full GPU load. And when it comes to noise levels, the Suprim Liquid was even quieter than the already quiet 5090 FE. Now the Suprim Liquid averaged just under 49 decibels under full GPU load, which was 17 decibels under the FE. If you want to know what the difference is, it's the difference between having some lo-fi on in the background and listening to the dulcet tones of a lawnmower ripping across your yard. And remember, we're not even using the silent BIOS mode. Now that we have a better picture of this GPU with performance and features, let's talk about who this is for. The way that we see it is this: the MSI RTX 5090 Suprim Liquid is anything but a standard GPU, and it really is best suited for users whose GPU use cases are anything but standard as well. So we're talking about people who are heavy GPU overclockers, rendering videos back to back, training AI models, crunching GPU-bound scientific equations, basically anyone who's pushing their GPU to the brink. And what makes the MSI RTX 5090 Suprim Liquid so good for these users? Realistically, these are the type of power users that are going to make real use of the RTX 5090's full potential. And for these type of tasks, keeping your GPU cool means that it has more headroom to work with. When we look at how good the cooling is and how the power scales with that cooling, man, it paints a picture for us that this card can really thrive when it's driven. That being said, we haven't even scratched the surface on what this thing can actually do. And this is when we need to talk about overclocking, because we don't typically talk about overclocking potential in videos like this because the silicon lottery is a real thing. You might pull a golden sample that would outpace our GPU, or you might get a dud. So this really is a thing where your mileage will absolutely vary. That being said, with how this GPU is designed and the fact that the water block covers both the GPU die and the VRAM, we see some untapped potential that really deserves a video of its own. As we start landing the plane here, we do have one big question to ask. Is a 50%+ price hike over the RTX 5090 FE's MSRP worth the price increase to this type of user that we just talked about? To put what we're asking into real numbers, we're looking at around a $1,000 difference here. While honestly, we can't answer this for these users, what we can say is this. If your job or your projects are GPU bound and the time it takes to complete them is dependent on sustained GPU performance, we can definitely see the appeal. After all, if you're able to win back time with the Suprim Liquid holding off GPU throttling while providing more headroom for power, that's a resource you can't really put a price tag on. There are definitely PC cases where this GPU will thrive, like the ones we listed before, or this one right here, but you're just gonna have to be mindful that this thing won't fit in every PC case. So you may need to look at a new case if you're considering this GPU. And with that, there you have it. That is the MSI RTX 5090 Suprim Liquid, a monstrously cool GPU with a few considerations for users who need a GPU that they can push. We do want to say a very special thank you to MSI for sending us this GPU for testing so that we can make this video for you. And as always, we want to know what you think about the MSI RTX 5090 Suprim Liquid. Do you like the idea of a liquid cool GPU? Where do you see GPUs like this one being beneficial? And if you're going to put this inside of a PC build, what case would you use? Let us know in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here at Robeytech. And if you want to continue the conversation, maybe talk about the case or the build that you're going to pair with a GPU like this, head over to our Discord server, discord.gg/Robeytech. Amazing place to meet to other tech and PC enthusiasts who love to have these conversations. You know what? You might just make a friend. Also, make sure you follow us on all your favorite social media platforms at Robeytech, absolutely everywhere. Thank you so much for making it this far, and we look forward to seeing you on the next video.